Jakarta, the second largest urban area in the world, could soon find itself underwater. With sea levels rising globally, many other coastal cities will face similar threats.
So right now we're standing on the North Jakarta seawall. On my right-hand side is the Java Sea, and on my left-hand side, about 2 meters lower, is North Jakarta, is the land of Jakarta. And this part of Jakarta has subsided, has sunk so much that if I stand on the other side of the seawall, I'm exactly 2 meters tall. I'm eye level with the boats, the hulls of the boat on this other side. If this seawall were to break, and it's already leaking in a few spots, about 40% of Jakarta would be flooded to a depth of 1 or 2 meters. It's quite a precarious situation.
In 15 years, 80% of Jakarta's northern part will lie below sea level.
The ground is sinking because there's so much groundwater being pumped up by individuals, by industries, by malls, by developments. What's happened in Jakarta because of this groundwater extraction is that the rivers don't flow downhill anymore. And basically have to be pumped over a seawall to drain.
51 people in the greater Jakarta area died in floods in 2013 alone. Water caused $3.3 billion worth of damage that year. Severe flooding has become an annual ordeal in Jakarta. Rising water leaves citizens struggling for their lives.
There's very little information available for the public, and even in some cases the government, about the flooding, on where is the flooding in Jakarta at this moment, what route can I take home that won't be flooded, right? Like, this very basic information about flooding doesn't exist. And so this is the void that the Peta Jakarta system is attempting to fill.
So what we basically do is say there's already an incredible social network in the city that's live and active and the people are using. When we have an emergency situation, in our case flooding, we can convert that network into an information gathering and dissemination system by simply running it through a different software.
PetaJakarta.org was created by two researchers at a university in Australia, Thomas Holderness and Etienne Turpin. It provides a real-time map of flooded streets based on social media reports.
There's between 10 and 70 centimeters of water, standing flood water in these neighborhoods. So this is real-time flood information on the behalf of the citizens and the governments being shared with everyone. This is quite exciting.
We listen to Twitter for conversations about flooding, and then we send an automatic invitation to people talking about flooding to share that information with others.
At the peak of the floods, hundreds of thousands of tweets populate the map.
While Peta Jakarta doesn't solve the fact that it will flood in Jakarta during the monsoon, it addresses the secondary fundamental problem of information. During an emergency situation, the number one resource is information. By disseminating that information in a non-trivial and real-time format, both the emergency management agency and the residents of Jakarta can make better decisions, reduce risk, and the collective behavior of that across the city has a tremendous impact that I don't even know any infrastructure engineering could achieve in the traditional sense.
What's happening in Jakarta is kind of leading the charge as far as other cities being affected by climate change. So it's only a matter of time before there's numerous US cities, particularly US coastal cities such as New York or Boston or San Francisco, that'll be experiencing similar issues of very severe flooding in a very large urban environment.
When that happens, the lessons and technology developed in Jakarta may be crucial for survival for urban dwellers around the world.